Hello everyone, today we will learn non-periodic digital signals. So let us start. In data communication, we commonly use non-periodic digital signals. Non-periodic means which do not repeat over time. Digital means discrete, and signal is time-varying voltage. So a time-varying voltage having discrete levels which do not repeat over time is called non-periodic digital signal. The discrete levels are represented as 0 and 1, where 0 is a low voltage and 1 is a high voltage. Here we see only two levels, where each level is sending 1 bit. A digital signal with more than two levels can send more than 1 bit. Mathematically, the number of bits that each level can transmit is calculated as log to the base 2 L, where L is the number of levels in the digital signal. Since there are 4 levels in the digital signal, so the number of bits per level is log to the base 2, 4, which comes out to be 2. So each level can send 2 bits. Similarly, if there are 8 levels, the number of bits each level can transmit is log to the base 2, 8, that is 3. Please note that the number of bits to represent one color pixel is 24. The parameters like frequency and time period deal with periodic signals. However, in data communication, we deal with non-periodic digital signals. Hence, instead of frequency or time period, we use the term bitrate for digital signals. The term bitrate is defined as the number of bits sent in 1 second. It is measured in bits per second or BPS. In this example, 8 bits are sent in 1 second. So, the bit rate is 8 BPS. A digital signal is represented by vertical and horizontal lines in the time domain. In vertical lines, the signal changes its state from low to high in no time. That is, time period is 0. Since frequency is inverse of time period, so frequency comes out to be infinite. In the case of horizontal lines, the frequency remains 0. So, in a digital signal, frequency ranges from 0 to infinity, which means a digital signal has infinite bandwidth. As it contains infinite frequencies, so it is a composite signal as well. The decomposition of a digital signal by Fourier analysis results in a composite analog signal, which can have either discrete or continuous frequencies. Discrete frequency means frequencies with integer values, for example, f, 2f, 3f, and so on. On the other hand, continuous frequency means the frequencies with real values, for example, 1.2f, 1.3f, 4.5f, etc. In the periodic digital signal, which is rare in data communication, the decomposed analog signal has infinite bandwidth and discrete frequencies. On the other hand, if the digital signal is non-periodic, then the decomposed analog signal will have infinite bandwidth and continuous frequencies. Having discussed the digital signals, now the question is, how to send a digital signal from source to destination? To transmit a digital signal, we can use either baseband transmission or broadband transmission. Let us first discuss the baseband transmission. In baseband transmission, the digital signal is transmitted via a channel or medium without changing it to an analog signal. We know that a digital signal is a composite analog signal with frequencies ranging from 0 to infinity. So, the channel to be used for baseband transmission should allow frequencies starting from 0 to infinity. That is, it should have infinite bandwidth. However, a channel with infinite bandwidth does not exist, but we can get close to it by using wide bandwidth channels. A low pass channel is the one whose bandwidth starts from 0. Let us consider two low pass channels, one with narrow bandwidth and the other with wide bandwidth. Let us first consider low pass channel with wide bandwidth. Suppose a non-periodic digital signal is given to the input of a wide bandwidth low pass channel. We know that a non-periodic digital signal is decomposed to a composite analog signal having infinite continuous frequencies. So, to reproduce the exact digital signal at the output, all analog signals within the composite signal should be transmitted. That is, signals with frequencies ranging from 0 to infinity should be transmitted. It is possible only if the two communicating devices have a dedicated medium with infinite bandwidth. Infinite bandwidth is not possible in reality. So, the mediums like coaxial cable or fiber optic cable, which offers very wide bandwidth, are used. Suppose the bandwidth ranges from frequency F1 to F2. The frequencies at the border of the digital signal, that is 0 to F1 and F2 to infinity, have very low amplitudes. So, they can be neglected. As a result, the wide bandwidth low pass channel does not deliver the exact digital signal but a similar digital signal from which the information can be extracted. Hence, to preserve a digital signal's shape, low pass channel with vast bandwidth should be used in baseband transmission. Now, low pass channel with narrow bandwidth. In a low pass channel with narrow bandwidth, a digital signal is approximated with an analog signal. Consider a digital signal with bit rate n and we are sending 3 bits, say 000, 010 and 001. The first bit pattern can be approximated with an analog signal of 0 frequency and a phase shift of 180 degrees. The second bit pattern can be approximated with an analog signal of n by 2 frequency and a phase shift of 180 degrees. The third bit pattern can be approximated with an analog signal of n by 2 frequency and a phase shift of 180 degrees. Therefore, the maximum frequency to roughly approximate a digital signal is n by 2 and the minimum frequency is 0 Hz. Hence, a bandwidth of n by 2 minus 0, that is n by 2, is required for a rough approximation of the digital signal. Note that the frequency n by 2 is called the first harmonic or the fundamental frequency. For a better approximation of the digital signal, more harmonics of the fundamental frequency or first harmonic should be used. For example, 3n by 2, 5n by 2. It better approximates the digital signal. If we check this in the frequency domain, we can find out that the better approximation has increased the bandwidth. It has increased from n by 2 to 5n by 2. We can also point out that the bandwidth is directly proportional to the bit rate in baseband transmission. Suppose we are using first 3 harmonics to approximate a digital signal. So, the bandwidth is 5n by 2. If the bit rate is 10 kbps, then the bandwidth is 25 kHz. If the bit rate is 100 kbps, then the bandwidth is 250 kHz. That is, to send bits faster, we have to increase the bandwidth. Now comes the broadband transmission. In broadband transmission, the digital signals are converted to composite analog signals and transmitted to the receiver via a bandpass channel, allowing frequencies ranging from F1 to F2 to pass through it. The frequencies below F1 and above F2 are discarded. Converting a digital signal to a composite analog signal is called modulation. At the receiver, the composite analog signal is converted back to a digital signal. It is called demodulation. Computer data sent by telephone subscriber line using modems is an example of broadband transmission. So in this video, we learned non-periodic digital signals, the number of bits transmitted per level, bit rate, decomposition of digital signal to a composite analog signal, and the transmission of digital signal by baseband transmission and broadband transmission. If you have learned something in this video, then please like this video. Share this video so that more people can learn. Subscribe to TechTerms if you want to learn more and turn the notification icon on. Thanks for watching.